Welcome class 5 in your e-learning EBS class as we are revising the very first chapter super senses and we have already revised different kind of senses and different type of behavior doing by the animals in different situations and how many types of functions they are doing with their super senses. Now today we will discuss the long sleep and awaking time of the animals. So the part is sleeping and waking. As we know, few animals go for the deep sleep or a long sleep in winter season and few of other animals go to sleep for a long time in a summer seasons. So there are two different kinds of animals and two different categories of animals who go for the deep sleep or the long sleep. But all animals do not go for the long sleeps, only few animals. So few examples are given here. Some animals go into long deep sleep in certain seasons. They are not seen for many months. Have you noticed that during the cold season you cannot see lizards in the house? Where do they think they have gone? So as we know, snakes, we do not see them in the winter season, as well as lizards we cannot see, or usually we don't see them in our on the walls and in our surrounding in the cold season. So what happens to them? Where they go? They go for the long deep sleep. So why they go for the long deep sleep? As they are the cold-blooded animals, and we know cold-blooded animals means the animals whose body temperature or the temperature of their blood changes with the temperature of the weather. If the weather become cold, if the season become cold, their body become changes into cold and their body cannot stay in a fixed temperature, just like us. They changes their body temperature and their body temperature changes according to the climatic condition. So in the cold seasons, their body or their blood become started to freeze and they are becoming cold. So that is the reason their metabolic activities, their all day activities becoming very slow. Their metabolic activity means the activity which goes inside their body. That means their walking problem, they are having their digestion problem, they are having their breathing problem. So all kind of functions, whatever is taking place inside the body, they are called metabolic activities. So these all metabolic activities becoming very slow due to this cold season and due to the decreasing rate of their metabolic activities, they become very slow moving and slow animals. So they go for the long sleep, and due to the slowing down of their metabolic activities, they become very lazy, or you can say they become unable to do all sorts of work. So they go for the long sleep. So the animals who go for the long sleeps in the winter, they are snakes and what are they? Snakes and lizards. And some animals which go for the long sleeps in the summer seasons, and these kind of sleeping in some animals, they are called estivations. And this estivation seasons, we see the prolonged torpor or the dormancy of the insects. So in the summer seasons, we see very few kind of insects, because maximum insects go for the long sleep, or their body activity, their metabolic activity becomes very slow. So they go for the long rest or long sleep. And this kind of activity is called, what they are called? Estivation. And like fishes and some kind of fishes and the amphibians, during the hot day, they hide themselves and they go deep inside the water or deep inside the soil and take rest. So this is the long sleep for amphibians, insects and few kind of fishes. Okay, so we came to know, and the other animals have different kind of sleeping habits that we will discuss. So one example I'll take today and another example we will take in my next video. So one example is sloth. Sloth is actually not a bear. It is a very, it looks like a bear, but it is not a bear. It spends almost 17 hours in sleeping. So it sleeps too much, 17 to 18 hours in a day. So how many hours are there in a day? There are 24 hours. If out of 24 hours, it is sleeping 18 hours. That means too much time it is sleeping. And while sleeping, it hangs its body on the branch of the tree. And just hanging its body, it sleeps. And then the sloth eats the leaves of the same tree in which it lives. So where it is sleeping, where it is living, the same plant or the same tree's leaf it eats. When it seems to them that leaves are becoming less in number and leaves are becoming decreasing, that time it changes it tree. So if the lifespan of sloth is 40 years, so within the 40 years, hardly it changes 7 to 8 trees. That means it has no other work, it has nothing to roam about. 18 hours of the whole day it sleeps, and another time it eats little bit, it awakes, and once in a week it comes down to relieve itself. Do you know what is the relieving? Relieving its body means it is excreting out the material or nitrogenous material from its body, that is poops and the urine. So it excretes out, and when it gets relieved, it again go up and climb up in the tree. So it is all about its lifespan and its life journey. So that's all for today, and next video we will discuss some more about animals and something more about the other animals, okay, and their sleeping time. Till that, goodbye, stay well, stay home, and take care of yourself.